Well, I'm running a fever, my voice is basically shot, and I can't stop my nose from running. So you know what that means. I'm sick as a dog. So let's play some Plague Inc. Hopefully that doesn't fuck with the mic too much. Alright, so what are we playing today? Well, that is a good question. Among my list... Hungry ticks. A lot of people fear bugs, mostly for what they look like, but now they will fear them mostly for what they can do. Actually, I think most people are afraid of bugs because of what they can do. Like that whole South American banana spider thing, that is crazy. Also, most houseflies are the leading causes of diseases throughout the entire house. Oh, and let's not forget, in the deep south of America, the United States that is, we have mosquitoes that can potentially carry malaria. So just gonna point out, I don't think that this has much of a leg to stand on. These bugs are ticks, deer ticks, can lead to several diseases, and they couldn't be more hungry. Yeah. Will humanity survive against these fearful bugs, or will the ticks gain superiority over humans? Neat! Oh, and this one's customizable. Fantastic. And of course, it's a parasite. Ticks. The ticks, members of the arachnid family. Are ticks a member of the... Well, I guess technically, they have 8 legs and 2 segmented body parts. Are hungrier than ever. So hungry, they'll even burrow into the depths of the human body just for a meal. Where will the ticks begin? Decide where they will be and spread from a few to the world. Where would ticks be? Usually, okay, well, I'm gonna start in America for no other reason than it's the only place I can think of to find ticks, which is probably very wrong of me, considering the parasites are all over the world. That's like saying that mosquitoes are only found in the Florida Everglades. That's entirely wrong. But, you know, I'm an arrogant American, so obviously I have no idea what I'm talking about 90% of the time. Ah, the Rio Olympics. Why? Well, okay. The Rio Olympics, I kind of know why that decision may be to postpone them, but it seems really weird that they would be already willing to postpone it due to a plague that has only infected 10 people. It's not really a plague, it's a new disease, and yeah, the medicine in America is slowing us down. So we'll go ahead and not look at the abilities yet. And just evolve from there. Ooh, what's this? Burrowing. Gross. Well, they seem to have done some on here. Ticks burrow into dermal layers, making them less noticeable and slightly decreasing efficiency. Oh, infectivity. My bad. Ticks burrow into subdermal tissue, making them less likely to be noticed. Increase in... Ha! You know, I like that. I mean, granted, we're not going to be spreading to basically anyone for a while, but I like the fact that we can basically control that. Because, yeah, I can't think of a plague that's done that, that's manipulated infectivity as much as that. And we should probably go with water. And I'll read those in a second. Since, you know, the important part is to start spreading. Beginning to spread, yes, even very slowly. Ah, 17. God damn it. I just need one more. There we go. Goldman Stanley Bank Crisis. Okay. Ticks produce eggs that are injected from the skin in the thousands, increasing infectiousness. Ticks can survive in warm, cold, or fresh or salt water, increasing travel speed through water. Pathogen able to survive the chemically tainted water increases infectivity, especially in humid climates, transmissions, blah blah blah. I did get that, and yes, I did. Good. Oh great, and we have now mutated rash. Eggs hatch when they experience an increase in warmth, likely due to being nearby human activity, greatly increases infectivity. And we'll get level 1 air. If only to help with plane travel and whatnot. That, and it appears that we have spread to Russia. Interesting. Alright, level 1 air. Then we'll go ahead and we'll get level 2, can't think of the word, medications, and we should be good. As long as we don't rapidly start infecting people and mutating spontaneously. That's 20-something, isn't it? Yeah, 29. So, we're gonna be here a while. Ha! I hate ticks. Absolutely hate them. Mostly because on a couple of occasions, after being at my uncle's house, I'll think I'll have... Ah, yes. Britain exiting the United Kingdom. I remember when that was a thing. Thanks, 2016. Even though it's 2018 in the game. But anyway... after a few trips to my uncle's house, I've pulled off ticks that I thought were moles, and yeah, that's kind of a little shocking when you rip off a mole and it becomes, you know, legged and whatnot. It'll make your skin crawl. But let's see. We have pretty high infectivity, and basically no drugs are going to be influencing us. So let's go ahead and increase our resistances to temperature, and since we've infected multiple countries in cold weather, that would probably be intelligent. And America is slowly being infected. 17. Okay. Whatcha? Alright. Headache, insomnia, anemia, and rashes. Okay. More infectious than HIV. Well, basically all of America has been infected, and we're infecting fast enough that we've got a good chunk of the population, then those deaths were not part of us. And now we mutated headache too. Fantastic. So I guess we're at the point where we just, you know, sit and wait. Oh, all of Russia already? Wow. You thought I didn't see you. You thought you were being sneaky, but you were wrong. Well, be an urban. Okay, well, up these if only to increase our infectivity a little bit more. And holy crap. Apparently, there was a spontaneous bird migration over a lot of areas. Seriously, jeez. I love it when that happens, but damn, I gotta pause the game and slow everything down, and yeah, how many countries have we not infected? Mostly just all of Africa and Madagascar. Well, as soon as we infect Madagascar, I guess we can start having a lot more fun. There we go. And now we have hallucinations. No, I don't want any lethality. Unfortunately, we have a little lethality, but no severity, weirdly enough. I have a feeling that's because we did this, so everybody's under the impression that they're just getting rashes from basically nothing. And since there's no blood, we might as well get mosquitoes. But yeah, I guess we'll just wait for a good chunk of Madagascar to get infected, and then we'll start becoming increasingly more lethal. I'll admit, I was hoping for a little bit more on this one, just because the idea was interesting, especially as an SCP. This just kind of seems like a afterthought. Yes, the new minor disease is spreading, which causes headaches, hallucinations, seizures, pulmonary fibrosis, inflammation, and rashes. You're a little late there, Finland. And yeah, I'm disappointed. Gastral ulcerations. Ugh. Okay, so tics form groups in the heads, headaches from behind the eyes cause discomfort, optical lesions are created, causing severe hallucinations, random blackouts and fits reduce patient's inability to function properly, skin becomes blistered and painful, inflammation obscures bodily processes, scarring of the lungs causes shortness of breath, multiple sores develop in the lining of the stomach, causing severe pain in the abdominal region. And yeah, I don't think there's basically any place on Earth that... Shit! I didn't want total organ failure yet. Angolia is totally just gonna... Angolia, Zimbabwe, and Argentina are just gonna keel over before I infect enough of them. Hold on. Poor and hot. So, we'll go with hot, genetic hardening, and livestock. That should increase our infectivity in these particular regions, so that way it doesn't cause us to... damn it. Botswana's totally gonna slip out from under our grasp. I'll wait. Yes! Okay, good. Actually, how much is the world? Oh, holy. Which countries of the world are dead? Oh! Damn it, we killed our way out of Greenland. So we lose anyway. Damn it. How many people are left in Greenland? Just slightly over 14,000. Is going to stop us from winning. What is that? Arid, hot, and poor. Yeah, not like it matters because we've totally lost. But basically, only these countries are stopping us from winning at this point. Yeah, mutating the total organ failure kinda dicked us right over. Because now Argentina is only about half dead. Botswana just bombed the infected cities. And Angolia is basically going to kill itself out of desperation. And memory loss symptoms! Fantastic! Here's memory loss. Paralysis. Oh, memory loss. Okay, well this one... Okay, despite the fact that I lost, this one was kind of mildly disappointing. I was expecting more from an SCP mod. Granted, that may be because I've been spoiled on some really good SCP mods, but this one just kind of seems, I don't know, lacking. It almost feels like this wasn't an SCP mod. This was just a parasite mod that was, or a parasite playthrough that was just slightly modified so that way it wasn't exactly like normal. But yeah, just mildly disappointing. And how many years did it take us to die from this? Just a little over 3.5. Just a little bit over 3.5 for humanity to completely eradicate the ticks. Alright, well, I'll see you guys in the next episode. This one was, not recommended.